Okay, good morning, everyone. I know we may not have everyone because of perhaps traffic and so on. If we're on mute, that's really helpful because then we can get going. So very, very pleased to introduce Rosie Dandy, who left in 2019 and is going to come back and tell you a little bit about her journey. She'll speak for a short amount of time, and then we'll go to the forums to see if you've got any questions. So please, while she's talking, if there's anything that comes to mind, write it down. And then when we go to the forums, you'll have an opportunity maybe to raise your hand and then ask the question. That would be really helpful because it'd be good to respond to the things that you're thinking about at the time. So tutors, just to say, if it gets close to the time when you need to leave at the end and we happen to be going on with interesting questions, don't worry, you are able to leave if the time is up. We appreciate that. Okay, Rosie, a very good morning to you and over to you. Thank you.
Yeah, so morning, everyone. I'll just share my screen because I've got a quick, some slides. Just need to click allow on settings. Privacy. Here we go. Done.
Over to you. You're back, I think.
Yeah, sorry about that. IT.
No worries. IT, exactly. IT.
Yeah, so as we've just introduced, I'm just going to tell you a little bit about my career so far since I left. So my slides are in the wrong place. So I what's that? Sorry about that. I think one of my slides has been deleted, but it's okay. So I started, when I started sixth form, I wanted to be a lawyer. Very different career to what I'm doing now. Then I did some work experience and decided that wasn't for me. Then I was a little bit left stuck. I did A-level psychology, history and business. And I was like, where do I go with these now? So I applied for university. Business degrees, thanks to Mrs. Jones, got my interest for business there. But in my head, I was kind of like, I don't know where I'm going to go with this degree. What am I going to do after it? I coached gymnastics and I thought, maybe I'll just end up coaching gymnastics, not using my degree, which is something that I didn't want to do. So I applied for AstraZeneca, which is a pharmaceutical company, and it was actually an IT apprenticeship. I was a little bit, do I do this? Do I not do this? Because I had lots of stereotypes regarding kind of IT is just a load of men in a room coding. That's not really for me. So did lots of research and realised, oh, actually, there is some IT degree apprenticeships, the digital technology solutions one, where you can move about the business, you can try new things, you can specialise in some not so techie almost fields. So I decided to apply for some apprenticeships. I still applied for uni, like I said before. It was my backup. Apprenticeships are, well, especially degree apprenticeships, are very hard to get in on. I think I applied for over 30, which was a lot of hard work on top of schoolwork, on top of kind of prepping for your ASs and things like that. My mum did help me a lot with that. I did also attend MMU's Aspire, Apply, Achieve course, which I'd recommend if you are thinking about going down the degree apprenticeship route. They kind of teach you all you need to know. When I applied, I think there was an online interview, a video thing that you had to submit online, and then you got through to the assessment centre. And then the assessment centre, we had a group task, like speed dating interviews. It was 10 people, 10 minutes. That's the group task. I had to do a presentation on my favourite technology. And what was the last thing? And then there was like a walk and talk where people were just checking your manners and just generically, how are you as a person? So that's kind of where I decided to go and how I applied. Then going on to kind of like work life. So as a degree apprentice, you do get given real life projects, real life tasks that add a lot of value to the company. You're not there to make cups of teas, etc. like that, which are some of the stereotypes that some people might have. AstraZeneca and a lot of other people do this as well. You get to go around lots of different departments and also do different roles as well. And that means you can understand where your strengths, where your interests lie. So I think I've done lots of different roles. I think business analyst, I was like, what even is that? But that was kind of, the scientists taught one language and the IT people talk another technical language, and almost like bridging the gap. So what do they want? What's their problem? And how do we translate that to? So almost just being like a translator between two technical languages. One of the benefits of this is also your networking. So you're going through, I think I did 5 different rotations, so 5 different job roles over the course of 4 years. So that meant that I got to know lots and lots of people, and that was also a good support network. And then it also has been very, very enjoyable. If I flash to this screen, I am aware it's very overwhelming. There's a lot of information. But just to give you a little snippet of what I've done. So I first started off in the project support as a project support officer in the UK IT footprint team. What I did there was help with the global deployment of Microsoft Teams in lockdown. So that was a huge scale project running at very, very fast pace. We were on Skype at the time, and it wasn't good enough to get everybody working from home and being productive. Then I moved on to doing a digital transformation project manager, where I delivered several automations. So GES is global external sourcing, that supply chain. So this was when AstraZeneca were delivering the vaccine. So everyone was running 110 miles per hour, had so many things to do. I was there able to automate some of their really boring manual tasks that had a lot of copying and pasting. So then we could push the vaccine out and allow them to have more time to do the value adding activities. Then I moved into being a business analyst and business relationship manager in operations IT. So they're kind of facing the people who make the medicines on the actual plants. So one of my favorite things that I did here was we found in IT, yes, we are quite digital, but when you look out into the rest of like manufacturing, etc., they do a lot of paper-based things. They do a lot of slow manual tasks. So I kind of got all of that leadership team together, and we identified pain points, like lots of slow manual work, and when we had technical people on the call as well, and they were able to say, oh, why don't we do this, why don't we do this. So we got about 15 different ideas, and by the time I left that rotation, we had delivered 5 of them and had a pipeline to deliver more. Then I went into user experience as a researcher and designer. This was one of my favorite roles. I think it was because I had a little bit of psychology in, and I always like psychology. So here, one example of the things that we did is we went and checked asthma adherence application that we'd created with patients to see, could they use it? Were the buttons too big? Were they too small? Would they normally click that, or would they expect to do this? And we also checked it with doctors as well, because we were pulling reports to see, would this actually be useful for you to see at a quick glance how to manage the patient's adherence better, or how to manage their asthma better. Then I went into to be a digital transformation project manager again, because I did like it in supply chain, but I went into operations this time. And this is, if you remember, I don't know if you all or not, when energy prices were like going through the roof, it was crazy, and kind of smart meterings had been deployed in your homes. I don't know if people have them, when you can look how much electric you've used that day or energy. Well, it was kind of the same, but on a much bigger scale. So we delivered one of them at Macclesfield Manufacturing Building, so where we make one of our blockbuster drugs, which is Zoladex. And that also helped, oh, there's a leak there, we can quickly change it, or there's a gas leak, we can quickly fix it before the bill goes sky high, or there's an effect on the medicines getting out the door and then affecting patients' lives. So that was really fun. And then the final one, which is what I wrote my dissertation on, was cybersecurity. So I kind of sent and project managed sending dodgy emails to the whole of AstraZeneca. So they were like, click on this link. Oh, you've we've got an email from Amazon. It's not a real email. And they were checking to see, would people click on them? Did they enter their email and password? Are we actually cyber secure? And then after that, we could tailor some training to specific types to say, you need to upskill on this. It's a danger in your area. And then when I've done all this, so I just graduated with a first MMU university. I got my permanent role as a business analyst. Now, it is quite hard to get permanent roles at big companies, especially like AstraZeneca. They like to put you on like as a contractor and then a fixed term role and then a permanent. So I think being with them on this journey and them investing in me, they saw the benefit and then decided to do that, which is absolutely amazing. Yeah, and just want to kind of add as well, I don't want to blow my own trumpet a little bit, but I did actually get a first and I got the highest grade in the year, which I never thought I would do. You've seen my kind of history a little bit at A level. I didn't do any GCSEs relating to computer science. I didn't do it at GCSE or A level. So yeah, it just shows with the right support around you and the can-do attitude and wanting to get involved in everything, you kind of will succeed. My motto was just jump at every opportunity, kind of trust that the safety net will be there. You can go out the meet and go, oh, I'm a little bit, I don't know how to do that. But your managers will want to be there and kind of support you. Otherwise, I wouldn't have done half the stuff I've done. So then kind of going on to university life, how does it work with the degree apprenticeship? So for me personally, it was one day a week. You're allocated 20%. This can be online or face-to-face, or sometimes people do it block learning. So my undergrad was a Friday. I'd go into university in person. However, my master's is going to be every month. I go in for 3 days. So it depends. It's something to look out for if you do want to apply. I think the degree apprenticeship is a minimum of 4 years. Obviously, you've got lots of different ranging apprenticeships. I'm going to do my level 7 now, which is my master's, so then that'll be 6 years. I wanted to kind of pull out here that some people might think, oh, an apprenticeship isn't for me because I want the social life, but there is often a lot of chances to relocate, and the companies want you to relocate because they get a diverse field, like more people applying, lots of different talent. So that's one to look out for. I think AstraZeneca offer you 5,000 as well, so it's quite a lot of money, a big incentive. And for going into uni, I have still had like the social side of it. Obviously, I've got to be up Monday to Friday to do work, but I've made friends with people from Barclays, Bentleys, Fujitsu, and we're kind of good friends now. We go on holiday, do the Otley Run. We've done a lot of like Teenage Cancer Trust charity events, so we've got like a good tight network. I was going to do a collage and there were so many pictures that it got overwhelming. So yeah, just want to add, you can have a social side whilst also being a degree apprentice.
Brilliant, Rosie. Thank you. Are we able to go to some questions, maybe?
Yeah, of course.
That's brilliant. I think, yeah,
we that was like my last one anyway.
Against us, unfortunately, but it'd be really lovely. So I don't know if there's anyone who has any questions. If there's any form that has a question, would you like to unmute and say yes, whichever form you are? Or the tutor might want to pass on a question from the form if the form isn't able to talk. Anyone from year 11 got a question? Anyone from year 10 got a question?
I'm chatting.
I've got a quick question if there's none around.
Yes. We've got some chat. Through. What a good idea. Can I read the chat quick enough? Okay. How did COVID affect your work and studies?
So for me, I really liked COVID, and I think it was because I was kind of involved. I think I was involved in such good work when I was in supply chain, like I said, doing some automations to get the supply of the vaccine out the door. I felt like empowered. I was really adding value, and I was almost saving, obviously, personally, I wasn't, but I was contributing to it in a wider sense. And I think it gave me a purpose. So some people that maybe weren't doing uni or were doing uni, they kind of might have been stuck or in a bit of a lull, whereas every day I was kind of talking to people and I was just continuing but at home,
Yeah.
really. I
No,
didn't
get
actually
that.
meet anyone in that team face to face. I did it all virtually.
Brilliant, Rosie. And quick questions. Where do you live? Do you live on a campus? They're really saying, you know, when you're doing your degree apprenticeship, where are you living? I think that idea of understanding that.
Yeah, so I live at home still. I think you can't move into like student hall, student accommodation, but you can. I know my cousin's girlfriend, she's doing the same degree apprenticeship, but she did move out, but just found different student accommodation. I think it's ones that aren't linked to the uni. And then some people who I know, they house share near Macclesfield, which is where my base is, rather than commuting.
Brilliant. And last question, what was your favourite role?
Oh, that's a tough one. I think it might have been either the digital transformation project manager, because I was like delivering, or the user experience researcher one, because that was getting the psychology in, understanding how people's brains work. Is that too big? Is that too small? Do they do that? How can we make it easy for them? And yeah, meeting doctors and meeting our patients, I felt really close to the science, which is the heart of AstraZeneca, which is what we do.
Well, it certainly sounds an amazingly varied apprenticeship. Amazing. So thank you so much for sharing that with us. Thank you very much, Year 10 and 11. We'll let you go because I know time's pressing. We'll stay on with you, Rosie, for a minute. Okay. Thank you, everyone. Have a good day.
See ya. Thank you.